Hollingford, in the shadow of the castle. Matilda's faction, commanded by her son Henry, proved it was still willing to fight King Stephen for the crown. But after 15 years of conflict, both sides had had enough. So, they made a deal. Matilda would surrender her claim to the throne on condition that when Stephen died, her eldest living son Henry would succeed him. A year later, he was crowned King Henry II and proceeded to grow the kingdom into the mighty Angevin Empire. But once again, what the king had spent his life building, his own children were destined to destroy. King Henry II had four surviving legitimate sons, and he planned to divide up his kingdom between them. But they fought bitterly for dominance. Against the odds, Henry's youngest son, John, became king. But King John was deeply unpopular. He lost huge swathes of the Angevin Empire gained by his father, then failed to reclaim them in expensive battles. Paid for by taxing his subjects. Eventually, England's barons could take it no more. They forced John to agree to a charter that restricted his power, the Magna Carta. But he went against his word. Furious, they rebelled, inviting Prince Louis of France to invade England. In 1216, Louis sailed to Dover and set his sights on taking this, Dover Castle. Held by forces loyal to King John, it was commanded by Hubert de Burgh. He described the castle as the key to England. He was right. If it fell to the French, so would the kingdom. Asked to invade by the rebel barons, Prince Louis's French army launched an assault on the castle at Dover. Opening a crack in the outer defenses, the invading forces charged the castle walls. The garrison at Dover would meet the French with clenched fists and an iron will. Dover could not fall. Commander Hubert de Burgh rallied his men to hold back the French and defend the castle.
Thank you.
While the castle's garrison thwarted the first French attack and prepared for a second, a new resistance force was building in the English countryside. A skilled bowman and fierce patriot, known as Willoughby of the Weald, began to muster a resistance to the French invasion. Determined to keep the crown in King John's hands, Willoughby would rally every available archer to the cause.
Set Nuthan, come upon.
With his bowmen assembled, Willoughby planned to ambush the French siege engines on their way to the enemy camp.
We have a steady debate, townfolk. Off to the fields.
Sister Hester. Stay we haven't stayed this be on that.
None sacketh up within armor.
Seath to Hestes.
Yeah.
If you'll go and flock a wooder. Ickle do that, Nuke.
Aye.
Ickle have that deep building or not.
Some French reinforcements made it to their siege camp, adding more numbers to their next attack on the castle. Willikin spotted a group of English fighters engaged in battle with the enemy and rushed to their aid. Willikin's band of archers made short work of the French reinforcements. But if they hoped to ease the burden on Dover's garrison, Willikin's ambush force could not relent.
Glidande ne hurt us, nor never down. Hester sewer they had.
Bolstered by the addition of their reinforcements, the French committed the full force of their army to a second assault on the castle.
Yes.
shall it do?
If he'll have that, yea, so are they hetten. If he'll build a that for they.
Manganel Yar. Under the way new.
Tolkas, Hestes, on the Fortas,
what shall he do?
And tendeth well, duende hit.
See, they to work at.
Hearken at all.
Will then they that rate the note?
Spellman, Yara.
Yarwe Shetham.
Tolkas.
With Willikin's archers weakening the siege from outside the castle, the garrison at Dover repelled the French attack. Willikin ordered his archers to resume their strikes on the French reinforcements.
Reaper railings aren't ongoing.
Freckus Harkin, New Hestus.
Willikin's resistance force continued to grow, adding more skilled men to its ranks.
I think they listen.
See thing to work, eh?
Arita, what needed worker? Eagle have us at
Arita, what needed worker?
Arita, what needed worker?
See thing to worker. Build end day that Rita new. And see build it.
It's the moon. It can't do.
Hestus on command.
Hey, every chat. Intended.
Cease to Hestus. Yeah. It kill build a that for they. That building will be reparailed anon.
Kempis, looked at for moveth, get a grace at yourself. He come fair and anew, a grace as we are going the Tolkas.
Yeah, Hestus! Hold the Fortas! Barret!
to done some work here.
Tulka, it's your way thine is.
Yara unto a marker.
What marker at all?
See, take a fair and older, every chat. You're anything haste that.
Upnan Ferreth, our way, men.
Every John, intended.
Yahweh Shetan.
You'll let me back, read the note.
If they may, yeah, but.
So with the head.
Crossbows, Yara on the way, tender.
Tres bullion de Hestus. It can they do.
Willikin's archers had decimated the French reinforcements. But undeterred, the French mustered what troops they could and launched another attack on the castle.
Yeah.
The hardy English garrison held fast, refusing to let the castle fall to the French invaders. Willekin rallied his archers to continue strikes on the weakening French.
Every charge, end 10 death. Build end day that treat anew.
Safe to hest, he'll do that now. Yara, on to a marker. Stirreth out there, every jack.
yet to be ready for Hestus. But mean a word, Ferris. For what their friends, mid Balvenes, mid a seeker for actors.
Always, Commander!
Leader is ready for Hestus.
On the stairs.
No, Tulkas, set it.
Yet they're ready, cross borders. Stir it yourself.
Hestus and Oldborn, Asteriath, Brathe are my men.
Hispana on the loaded. Crossbow up they wear.
Yet they're ready for fourth guarde frecus, mid Baldenes.
On, Bowman. Bail sleepily on the stairs.
Yes, yes,
step into it, Arway men.
Harken at all.
The stairs. We haven't stayed, is beyond that.
Reader, is he ready for Hestus?
He had a Hestus.
Ickle do that. Boon, Reader, is best to spend.
Who stayed to Luthan? Come upon.
The combined grit of the English garrison and Willikin's surprise attacks ensured that Dover hadn't fallen yet. Now the English prepared to repel the final French assault.
Caesar,
The tenacity of Hubert de Burgh's loyal soldiers forced Prince Louis and the rebel barons to abandon their siege at Dover. And thanks to the efforts of Willoughby's fearless archers, England remained in King John's hands.